So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 21st and 22nd of January 2023. And I hope the preparations are going well. मैं हर क्लास में यही होप कर रहा हूँ आपसे कि आपकी प्रिपरेशन अच्छी चल रही है. But अगर due to any reason, if it is not going good, please gear up now and just start your preparation from today only. Now let's talk about the very first question, which is about the Rashtriya Bal Puraskar. So President Draupadi Murmu will confer the Pradhan Mantri Rashtriya Bal Puraskar 2023 upon 11 children for their exceptional achievement. So you have to identify the incorrect statement about this award, right? So let's talk about this award. So the 2023 edition will be conferred upon 11 children by President Draupadi Murmu. And in various fields like art and culture, bravery, innovation, social service and sports. So out of 11, 4 awards will be given in the field of art and culture, 1 in the field of bravery, 2 for innovation, 1 award for social service and 3 awards in the field of sports, right? And total there are 6 boys and 5 girls out of total 11 children who will receive this award, right? Now talking about this award, so the objective of this award is to celebrate the energy, celebrate the determination, celebrate the passion of children of the country. It is being administered by Ministry of Women and Child Development, which is headed by Smriti Zubin Irani. Eligibility, any children who is a citizen of India and between the age group of 5 and 18 years, right, can have this award. And each awardee is given a medal and a cash prize of rupees 1 lakh along with the certificate. All right, so that is enough about these awards. Isse zyada aapko padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. And do remember, in the 2023 edition, 11 children will be awarded with this prize, out of which 6 are boys and 5 are girls. And the awards are given in 6 categories, right? These are the categories: art and culture, bravery, innovation, social service and sports. Total 5 categories the awards will be given this year in the 2023 edition. All right, so now let's identify the incorrect statement here. It is administered by Ministry of Women and Child Development. Sahi baat hai. Children in the age group of 5 to 18 years are eligible. Absolutely correct. It is awarded to both Indian citizens as well as foreigners. No, the children should be an Indian citizen to get this award. So that means option C is incorrect statement. Option C is the correct answer. All right, now let's talk about question number 2. Which of the following sectors affected by COVID-19 pandemic were recently given one-time relaxation for export obligation under the Export Promotion Capital Goods Scheme? Now this scheme, is a scheme ke baare mein zyada detail mein padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. There is no need to discuss this scheme in much detail because this is quite a technical scheme jisme se generally exam mein question nahi pucha jayega, right? But because it is in news, so क्या news है वो पढ़ लेते हैं, थोड़ा एक इसका brief idea ले लेते हैं, right? So we will only have a brief idea about this scheme. So the news is that the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, right? Piyush Goyal is also the leader in Rajya Sabha and also the Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. So the Ministry of Commerce and Industry has given a one-time relaxation. One-time relaxation has been given. Has been given for what? For export obligation under Export Promotion Capital Goods Scheme. Now, what is this export obligation? What is this scheme? We'll talk about it. Don't worry. And this has been given for this relaxation has been given to those sectors who were affected by COVID-19 pandemic, right? And of course, this relaxation will help these sectors to cope with the negative impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. All right. Now talking more about this, so only three sectors will get the benefit of this relaxation: hotel, healthcare and education, right? This is very important. This will definitely be asked in your examination, that which three sectors have been given the relaxation under this scheme. So the sectors are hotel, healthcare and education, right? Now talking about relaxation, what relaxation has been given? So they, under this scheme, under the EPCG scheme, there is an export obligation which every exporter has to follow, right? Unke upar ek export obligation hai jo ki unko pura karna hota hai. They have to complete that export obligation. नाउ दैट एक्सपोर्ट ऑब्लिगेशन, उस एक्सपोर्ट ऑब्लिगेशन में इनको रिलैक्सेशन दिया गया है. वट एवर इज द एवरेज एक्सपोर्ट ऑब्लिगेशन दे हैड टू मेंटेन, नाउ देर इज अ रिलैक्सेशन ऑन दिस एक्सपोर्ट ऑब्लिगेशन. राइट, आई होप यू गॉट माय पॉइंट. नाउ वट इज दिस एक्सपोर्ट ऑब्लिगेशन, दैट इज डिफरेंट फॉर एवरी सेक्टर, और ये काफी नंबर्स वाली गेम है, तो दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एग्जाम. राइट, नाउ एक्सटेंशन की अगर हम बात करें तो इट विल बी एक्सटेंडेड फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ एक्सपायरी फॉर द ड्यूरेशन इक्विवेलेंट टू द नंबर ऑफ डेज द एक्सपोर्ट ऑब्लिगेशन पीरियड फॉल्स within February 1st 2022 and 31st March 2022. Now for example, let's say between this period, my business had this relaxation from 1st of January to 31st January 2022, which means for a period of 1 month, right? And this period falls within this period, February 1st 2022 and March 31st 2022, right? So if I had the relaxation for a period of 1 month, then after this relaxation, this extension of relaxation, my relaxation would be extended for another 1 month only, right? But subject to a condition that my earlier relaxation period falls within this period, right? जो मेरा export obligation period था वो इसके बीच में होना चाहिए, only then I would be able to get the relaxation. I hope this thing is clear. Let me explain it once again. So read it again. It will be extended from the date of expiry. Let's say the date of expiry was 31st January 2022. Okay. And it started from 1st of January 2022 for a period of 1 month. Right. Equivalent to the number of days, the export obligation period falls within this period. So this period, 1st January 2022 to 31st January 2022 falls within this period or not? Yes, it falls. Right, now I will get the relaxation on my I was getting this much relaxation on my export obligation for a period of 1 month. Right, now after this extension I would be getting another 1 month of extension, another month, another 1 month of relaxation. Okay, I hope this is clear. And now talking about this scheme, so the objective of this scheme is to facilitate the import of capital goods. Now you must be wondering, क्या अभी तो आप बात कर रहे थे एक्सपोर्ट एब्लिगेशन की और अब आप ऑब्जेक्टिव में बता रहे हो कि ऑब्जेक्टिव है इसका टू फैसिलिटेट इंपोर्ट ऑफ कैपिटल गुड्स. प्लीज वेट, एवरीथिंग विल बी क्लियर, नो वरीज. सो ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्कीम एंड ऑफकोर्स द नेम इज ऑल्सो एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन कैपिटल गुड्स स्कीम, देन हाउ द ऑब्जेक्टिव कैन बी फैसिलिटेटिंग इंपोर्ट्स. प्लीज वेट, टू फैसिलिटेट इंपोर्ट ऑफ कैपिटल गुड्स for producing quality goods and services and enhance India's manufacturing competitiveness. So basically what government is doing under this scheme is that government is promoting the import of capital goods. With the help of those capital goods, the manufacturers are enhancing their manufacturing capabilities and those manufactured goods are promoted to be exported from the country. ठीक है, वो जो manufactured goods है उनकी export promotion की जा रही है. All right. See, there are certain capital goods which are not available in the Indian market. So what manufacturers are doing, they are, you know, importing those goods and preparing a final product. So what government is doing here, government is providing duty-free import of capital goods. Now with the help of this duty-free import of capital goods, what would happen? Isse hoga ye ki jo unka manufacturing cost hai, wo kam hoga. So wo motivate honge to enhance, to increase their production. And of course, it will increase the export. So this is how the government is promoting export of capital goods under this particular scheme. All right, I hope this is clear. And now let's come back to the question. So which three sectors will get the relaxation? These are hotel, healthcare, and educational. So which means option A, 1, 2, and 3 only will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3. Where was the regional conference on e-governance recently organized by the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances to discuss ways to improve e-service, digital platforms and e-governance models in India? Right. So you just have to tell the place where it was organized, and it is already given in the question that it was organized by DARPG, Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. Right. Now remember, it was organized in Mumbai. It was organized in Mumbai which is of course in Maharashtra, and the objective was to create a common platform to share experiences in formulation and implementation of best practices in these four areas. Now, what are these four areas? All these four areas are related to the governance only. Number one is administrative training. Number two, capacity building to facilitate citizen-centric governance. Number three, improved public service delivery through e-governance. And finally, transparent, accountable, and citizen-friendly effective administration. Right now, do you have to remember these four areas? No, not at all required for the examination. Just remember that e-governance regional conference took place in Mumbai, and it was organized by DARPG in collaboration with Maharashtra government. This question can also be asked, that in collaboration with which state government the conference on e-governance took place in Mumbai, and the answer would be Maharashtra government, right? And the theme, of course, the theme was e-governance. Theme kya tha? E-governance tha. All right. So question number 3. So where it was organized? It was organized in Mumbai in collaboration with Maharashtra government with the theme e-governance. Okay. So now let's talk about question number 4, which is about Y20, or you can say Youth 20. Youth 20 is nothing but Youth Wing of G20. Youth Wing of G20, where basically it is a platform to discuss the issues related to the youth of the G20 member nations. That's it. इससे ज्यादा यूथ 20 के बारे में आपको जानने की जरूरत नहीं है, राइट? सो द फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ Y20 ग्रुप अंडर इंडियाज G20 प्रेसिडेंसी विल टेक प्लेस इन असम. वेयर इन असम? वेयर? इन गुवाहाटी, इन द मंथ ऑफ फेब्रुवरी 2023. इट विल बी द फर्स्ट ऑफ द वेरियस मीटिंग्स टू बी हेल्ड ऑन द 5 Y20 थीम्स अक्रॉस इंडिया इन अ रन अप टू द फाइनल Y20 समिट विच टेक प्लेस इन द मंथ ऑफ अगस्त 2023. Which of the following are amongst the 5 Y20 themes under India's G20 president? So Y20 की 5 थीम है, आपको बताने हैं कि इनमें से कौन सी 5 में से है या क्या 5 ही यही है, राइट? सो तो Y20 समिट की Y20 मीटिंग, द फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ Y20 विल टेक प्लेस इन गुवाहाटी असम इन फेब्रुवरी 2023. आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू. नाउ द 5 थीम्स आर फ्यूचर ऑफ वर्क, क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड डिजास्टर रिस्क रिडक्शन, peace building and reconciliation, youth in democracy, and health, well-being, and sports. So these are the 5 themes based on which the Y20 meetings will take place across the country, and the very first meeting will take place in Guwahati in Assam. All right. So future of work, climate change and disaster risk reduction, peace building and reconciliation, youth in democracy, all 5, which means option E. All of the above will be the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 5 then. Which ministry has released a guide endorsement know-hows for celebrity influencers and virtual influencers on social media platform? So if any celebrity is endorsing a product, then usko uske bare mein wahan pe batana padega that it is an advertisement. Aisa hota hai na, jaise ki hum advertisements mein dekhte hain ki agar दीपिका पादुकोण ने कोई क्रीम लगाई वो गोरी हो गई, तो ऐसा होता कुछ नहीं है कि क्रीम लगाने से गोरे हो जाते हैं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता, बकवास है. तो ऐसी चीजों को देख के जो कंज्यूमर्स जो इधर उधर भटकते हैं, राइट, उनका बेवकूफ बनता है, उस चीज को रोकने के लिए दिस एंडोर्समेंट गाइड हैज बीन रिलीज बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स फूड एंड पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, राइट? सो इट इज एंडोर्समेंट नो हाउस एंड इट हैज बीन लॉन्च फॉर celebrities, influencers and social media influencers जो कि advertisement करते हैं, right? And it will protect consumers from being misled by advertisements. Misled का मैंने आपको example दे दिया कि अगर कोई actress cream लगा के गोरी हो रही है advertisement में, तो ऐसा of course नहीं होता. और वैसे भी skin गोरी करके क्या करोगे भाई, गोरा होना है तो मन से गोरा हो, काला मन लेके क्या करोगे, गोरा skin लेके कोई फायदा नहीं है. Now objectives. To ensure that individuals do not mislead their audiences when endorsing products or services. To ensure that they are in compliance with the Consumer Protection Act of 2019. And also, it mandates display of endorsement with used terms like endorsement, advertisement. Right? इस तरीके के words वहाँ पे होने चाहिए that I am advertising this. Right? ऐसा नहीं कि मैंने कह दिया विराट कोहली ने कह दिया कि गो आई बीबो अच्छा है, या वो कौन है गो आई बीबो की ब्रांड एम्बेसडर है, फॉरगेटिंग हर नेम दैट एक्ट्रेस, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि गो आई बीबो अच्छा ही होगा, वहां पे उसको बताना पड़ेगा दैट इट इज एन एडवर्टीजमेंट। ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज ऑल, एंड द करेक्ट आंसर इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स फूड एंड पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 पे आ जाते हैं, वेयर विल द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म ऑर्गेनाइज द फर्स्ट ग्लोबल टूरिज्म इन्वेस्टर समिट इन अप्रैल 2023 टू ब्रिंग टुगेदर ग्लोबल बिजनेसेस, थॉट लीडर्स एंड पॉलिसी मेकर्स टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड एक्सप्लोर द टूरिज्म बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन इंडिया। सो बेसिकली द मिनिस्ट्री इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म हेडेड बाय जी के रेड्डी, हेडेड बाय हूम, जी के रेड्डी, एंड इट विल बी द फर्स्ट ग्लोबल टूरिज्म इन्वेस्टर समिट, राइट, इट विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज इन न्यू दिल्ली, राइट, कहां पे ऑर्गेनाइज होगा, ये न्यू दिल्ली में होगा। नाउ व्हाई, टू ब्रिंग टुगेदर ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड एक्सप्लोर द टूरिज्म बिजनेस इन द कंट्री। ऑलराइट, तो यही है, सो न्यू दिल्ली में होगा ये, प्रगति मैदान में, आई होप प्रगति मैदान जो दिल्ली के लोग हैं उनको पता होगा, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग मिनिस्ट्री हो गया इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल 2023। ओके, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम डावोस मीटिंग एनुअल 2023 की जो मीटिंग अभी हुई उसके बारे में बात कर लेते हैं। सो इंडियाज फोकस एरियाज आर एट वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम आर इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर लैंडस्केप एंड इट्स इंक्लूसिव एंड सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ, दीज वर द फोकस एरियाज ऑफ इंडिया एट वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम 2023 मीटिंग। सो आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट अबाउट वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम, हमें क्या करना है, इकोनॉमिक वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम के बारे में इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट पकड़नी है, ठीक है। तो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम डावोस। सो इंडिया हैज रीइटरेटेड इट्स पोजीशन, क्या क्या चीजें हुई पहले उसके बारे में, और उसके बाद फिर हम वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम के बारे में स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई करेंगे। सो इंडिया हैज रीइटरेटेड एज इट्स पोजीशन एज ए रेजिलिएंट इकोनॉमी, राइट, इंडिया ने अपनी पोजीशन को बरकरार रखा है और बताया है दैट वी आर ए रेजिलिएंट इकोनॉमी विद अ स्ट्रॉन्ग लीडरशिप लाइक आर प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी जी, वाइब्रेंट प्राइम मिनिस्टर, providing stable policy to global investors at World Economic Forum annual meeting which takes place every year in Davos, right? India's focus areas were majorly two, investment opportunities and infrastructural landscape and its inclusive and sustainable growth. These two focus areas are very important, you should remember it, right? Now during the entire meeting, DPIIT, which is Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, it hosted three lounges to further strengthen India's position. And these three lounges were number one India Lounge, number two India Inclusivity Lounge, and number three was India Sustainability Lounge. Right? So, ये क्या है इनके बारे में डिटेल में जानने की जरूरत नहीं है. Just two three lines about these lounge. So India Lounge, it will be the focal point. It was actually the focal point of India's all businesses engagement taking place on the sidelines of World Economic Forum annual meeting 2023. ठीक है? जो भी इंडिया की business engagements है, उसको represent करने के लिए India Lounge was there. Then India Inclusivity Lounge. Through this lounge, India represented the voice of small enterprises, the artisans, the handicrafts people, right? And it showcased the handmade products that represents years of rich Indian heritage. All right. Then third, it was India's sustainability lounge, through which India showcased its new and emerging technologies to address the climate change. Right. Climate change ko address karne ke liye what India is doing using the new and emerging technologies. It was represented at India Sustainability Lounge, right? And these technologies are based on these five areas, which are energy, natural resource management, sustainable infrastructure and mobility, food and nutritional security, and circular economy. ठीक है जी? And now let's try to identify the incorrect statement about World Economic Forum. It is a specialized UN agency for public-private cooperation. I believe this is incorrect only. ये इनकरेक्ट है, ये कोई स्पेशलाइज्ड यूनाइटेड नेशन एजेंसी नहीं है, दिस इज इनकरेक्ट, राइट। तो बाकी भी पढ़ लेते हैं, इट वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1971 बाय क्लॉस श्वाब, हु इज करेंटली द यू नो इज द चेयरपर्सन, एग्जीक्यूटिव चेयरपर्सन ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम। हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन जिनेवा इन स्विट्जरलैंड, इन जिनेवा, विद इन जिनेवा, इट इज लोकेटेड इन कोलोनी, राइट, कोलोनी. इट इज फेमसली नोन फॉर इट्स एनुअल मीटिंग विच हेल्ड एट द एंड ऑफ जनवरी इन डावोस, राइट. द थीम ऑफ 2023 मीटिंग इज कोऑपरेशन फॉर सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ एंड शेयर्ड प्रॉस्पेरिटी. ऑल द फोर स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट, ऑप्शन ए इज इनकरेक्ट. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चंस इन शॉर्ट विच डू नॉट नीड मच एक्सप्लेनेशन. सो बिफोर दैट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन, ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम चैनल. And yeah, if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here, right? And only related to examination, by the way. Question number 8. Road Safety Week was observed from 11th to 17th of January 2023 under Swachhata Pakhwada to propagate the cause of safer roads for all. It laid emphasis on multiple initiatives across all the four E's of road safety. This is important. What are the four E's of road safety? That is the question. So remember, the four E's of road safety are engineering, enforcement, education and emergency care. Which means option A, 1, 2, 3 and 4 is the correct answer. And do remember the date, 11 to 17 January, the road safety week was observed. Because sometimes, is tarike ke question bhi pucha jate hain. Question number 9. Where will the first meeting of environment and climate sustainability working group under India's G20 presidency be take place? So it will take place in Bangalore. Option D is the correct answer, and I believe there is no need of explanation in this news, right? Question number 10. Where has the Millets and Organics 2023, the 3-day international trade fair, been organized to connect and explore the opportunities in agriculture, horticulture, processing, machinery and agri-tech in millet sector? And now I believe that you all know that 2023 is the International Year of Millets. Now this took place in Bangalore again. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 11. Where has the National Conclave of Pastoral Youth organized by Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying to discuss their aspirations, challenges and the need for polity discourse with the government? This is something interesting because this time the place is very different. It took place in Bhuj. Option C is the correct answer. And question number 12. Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency, IREDA, has signed an MOU with Ministry of New and Renewable Energy headed by Rajkumar Singh for setting up annual performance target for this financial year. So what revenue target has been set for IREDA as per this MOU? This is an interesting question. And for the financial year 2023, the revenue target for IRA has been set at rupees 3,361 crores. All right. And question number 13, as part of this summit for Democracy Year of Action, India, through the Election Commission of India, is leading the democracy cohort on election integrity to share its knowledge, technical expertise and experiences with other democracies of the world. Summit for Democracy is the initiative of which country? It's a very basic question and bahut easy, I believe. Summit for Democracy is the initiative of United States of America. All right, guys. So that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next session on Friday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.